Hey everybody, this is Eric Clark's Travel Videos, and I'm in Arizona. Wait, not Arizona. I'm in Budapest, Hungary, but I bought some chilies. I got into a kind of a conversation, and it was kind of a mixed conversation because she didn't really speak a whole bunch of great English, but about the chilies, and they were on sale, and I guess not very many people buy them, but so I found three really great chilies, and so I'm gonna roast them, I hope, in this little grill. So they don't have a gas stove, so I can't do that, and they don't have a gas burner, like a oven, or either one, and so I can't do it that way, but they've got a little toaster oven. Can an Arizona boy do a green chili in a little tiny stove? Let's go check. I'll be back.
Look at those green chilies. Wow. Man, Hatch in Arizona, or actually New Mexico, would be pretty proud of those kind of green chilies. So those are the green chilies. But we know, I don't know. My mom used to roast them all the time. And then she would make, put the cheese in it and maybe a piece of ham and then bread it and then dip it in egg sauce, but whatever, it doesn't matter. So this is the green chili, but you know that the skin isn't good to eat. And so we got to figure out what to do. And so that's what I got. I got a little tiny little oven. Oops. Can I get my drawer out of there? So I guess my question is, can I get these close enough in there to, without touching it, to get it to where it, I think that would work, don't you? And so I guess I'm gonna give this a ride and see. So I got to set up my sweat bag. And so, I don't know, my mom, when she always did this, she would always have a Ziploc baggie like this. And then she would, once they were cooked, she would wrap them in a moist paper towel and then stick them in there and let them sweat. And I guess that helped take off the skin. So anyway, let's give this a try, shall we? So this is roasting green chilies in a toaster oven in Budapest, Hungary. Let's rock it. Okay, so I've got it set. If you can look here on the top, I've got it set for a top burner. So I'm gonna turn that on and get that going. This one sticks out a titch. So I'm gonna kinda spin these a little left and a little right. And then that red burner should start coming on here soon. And then I've got my baggie. And then what I'll do is, once it starts getting done, I'm gonna then turn on the hot water, wet my paper towels, wrap them in the paper towels, stick them in here, and then let it sit for a while. And so this might take a little while. I can feel it getting hotter, but you know what? It is amazing how green chilies smell when they're roasting. They are just incredible and amazing. And so we'll see how this goes. I've never really done it this way, but it should be a hoot. And obviously I'm in a little tiny kitchen, and I've got some oranges and potatoes and all that kind of stuff. Anyway, so this is my my setup, and I'm gonna try to roast these green chilies. They were only like, I think, $3. So $1 a green chili, and whereas a bell pepper, I bought a bell pepper that was like $3. So anyway, neither here nor there. Let me get this going, and I'll come back to you. Bye. Okay, you can see, oh my God, they smell wonderful already. But I think that the heat is getting past it, but I don't know. So I was thinking about doing this. I found a little tray, and so I was thinking maybe I could just stick them on there and stick that in there and see if that helps. Let me try that and see what we get. I'll be right back. Okay, I had to cut the stems off because they didn't fit in the little oven. But see where it's starting to blister? That's exactly what we're looking for. And that'll take the skin off. And I can't tell you, oh my gosh, it smells so heavenly. Man, incredible. Okay, so let's get this back in here and see. I don't want it to touch that burner though. And I think I'm clearing it just fine. I guess I could lower it a titch, but there's no real titch. It's either that or 2 inches down. And then I don't know if it's going to do its job. But let's try that, and we'll see. And let's throw away these stems. And then we don't need the scissors anymore. Mama always said, clean as you go. And so I try to do exactly that. All right, so let me get these blistered and cooking, and then I'll come back. Bye. Okay, so, ooh, you can hear it blistering. And you can see it blistering. I just realized there's another problem. I don't have a pot holder. Oh, I do have a pot holder, but it's this huge thing. But there's no way to grab that little tiny thing with that monster. So I'm going to have to go find a towel or a washcloth or something. But, oh, my gosh, can you smell it? Oh, it smells wonderful. Also, I got on the internet to look for any way of toasting green chilies in a toaster oven, and nothing came up. Sure, any person and their brother can do it in a stove, but doing it in a toaster oven is a little different. And doing it in Hungary, where you can't tell what the numbers mean or the signs. But anyway, neither here nor there. We're going to make this work. I'll be back. Okay, I dug through the drawers and I found this little thing, and I never knew what it was, but I think that's what that's for, it's a little holder. Look at that. Oh my gosh, I can't tell you how good it smells. How good it smells. Mmm. Okay, well, let's turn those over and let's stick them back. And this thing just sucks. Whoever invented this should have been doing something else for a living. What a piece of crap. Anyway, okay. Because if it fell, I mean, you'd want to grab it and then you'd be in trouble. Okay, so let's see if it starts blistering for us. You know what I need to do is I need to get my phone so I can give you a light. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I got a light now. Let's see if we can see it pop. You can hear it. Ooh. I bet that one's gonna pop here soon. So we're trying to blister the skin off because the chili's what we want, and that's underneath. I don't even know that. I mean, Do Budapest Hungarians know how to do this? You can see one forming right there. Getting darker. Okay. Well, I guess I better pull them and make sure they don't burn. I'll be right back. Pretty exciting. Oh man, shut the door. Is that amazing? They're getting closer. Ooh, they're getting soft. We need to get the rest of them. Oh, you can see it steaming. Oh, that's wonderful. That one's a long one, and it's hard to, I wonder if I can, there's no way. Well, I'll try it, what the hell. Let's see if we can get this in there without killing ourselves here. Okay, more bacon. I'll be back. Oh. The whole entire house smells Like we, oh my gosh, look at that. Oh my gosh. It smells so wonderful. All right, so I think, look at that one. It's gonna pop. See how firm it is and hard? That's because the shell is popped up. Let's see if we can, oh, that's a good spot. And let's, that one looks good too. All right, see how that one just deflated? Let's try this again here. Oh, man, that little handle is a, I'd rather have a pair of pliers. Anyway, okay, let's put that back in there for a couple minutes. Oh, can you smell that? Oh my gosh. Oh, and they're not hatch green chilies, but man, they just are amazing. Welcome home, Eric. We're back in Arizona. Okay, let's see how these are looking now. Wow, okay. So they're blistering up pretty good. That one, man, that looks really, oh, there's a spot that I need to cook. And that spot needs to cook. So you're trying to get them all dark, because then it means it blisters, and it means that the skin is, sit down, would you? Is easier to peel off, because trying to peel these things is really hard. So we're just blistering the skin away from the green chili itself. Oh, I can't tell you how good it smells. Oh my gosh, they're just absolutely wonderful. Wow, we're getting close. Okay, so then I gotta get my bag and my paper ready. So what I'll do then is, I'll run some hot water. I keep missing my focus thing here. I'll get some hot water going, because you want it to steam. And so they're gonna continue to steam. And so what I'll do is I'll take some of these, get it hot as I can get the water going. He put a little bit of hot water on this, put the green chilies in here, and then wrap them and stick them in the bag. And then I'll just let it sit for probably 10 minutes, and that steaming will help cook the skin off the chilies. Does that make sense? Are we good with this? So I don't know. I guess I just assume that most people have done this before. Maybe people don't. I don't know. But anyway, this is how you do it in Budapest, Hungary, in a toaster oven. Okay, bye everybody. Wow, they smell wonderful. Okay, look at that one back there, how puffed up it is. You'll see it, it'll start to deflate. You can see the juices are flowing. I think that looks really good. Let me, oops, man, I'd be pissed as hell if that little thing fell off there. Okay, let's get that, because see now this is green? You really want it to be dark, like that one. There's a little bit of green there too. Because if it's green, now see how, now I'll give you a perfect example. Let me get my little fork here. Do you see on this one here how the skin is peeling off? That's what we want to get rid of. Eating that is like, you might as well chew on a tire. We don't want to chew on a tire. We want chili, not this. And if you buy a crap can of green chilies, you get a lot of those little pieces. Well, we don't want any part of that. All right, so I'm going to put this back in here, because I think we are about ready to rock and roll. So let me put that in there. And what I'm going to do then is, in about 2 minutes, I'm going to come and get this hot. I guess I'll start running my water. Wow. All right, Eric, stop saying wow on the smell. You know, it's the little things that make things home. All right, let me get this hot. Let me get my... my paper towel is warm, and then let me get my stuff rocking and rolling, and we'll do this together. I'll be back. Okay, my water's running hot. You know, it's funny, I opened the front door, and that one's still not done. I'm gonna let that cook a little bit longer. I opened the front door, and an elderly lady came by, and she said something in Hungarian, but I think she can smell the green chilies. And so I don't know. I assume that every country does green chilies the exact same way. But anyway, marvelous. And it's a gorgeous day. Cool. Okay. We're still working on our green chilies. Bye, everybody. All right, I think we're just gonna be done with this. And the timer went off, so. Okay, so that's my green chilies. So, now what we're gonna do is, we're gonna take this, and here's what I do, I don't know. So I just put some warm water on these things, and it's pretty hot water. And then I'm gonna turn that off, and then I'm gonna take these, because they don't have hot tongs. And I'm gonna slide these, hot. Youch. Over to here. I guess I'll use a fork, huh? Let me get these a little closer. Oh, I should have done that a little bit more. And then I wrap them. And then we're gonna take these, and I'm doing this totally different. All right, so now I gotta do this. Hang on. Be patient here, everybody. Let's not drop my camera in the water. Then I take these. Ooh, they're hot. And I stick it in here. And then I'm gonna take this and zip this shut and get all the air out that I can so that it can steam. And then what we'll do is we'll just let that sit. And you'll see that bag get big. So that bag will start to grow as the steam, and then, so it's still cooking inside of there. And that's exactly what we want. And so here in about, 5 minutes, I'll open it back up and we'll pull that off. And so now I got some dishes to do. Okay, moving on. I'll be back. Okay, like I said, the bag gets pretty big. And so it's pretty warm. And so it's still cooking. And that's what we want, right? We want it to keep cooking the chilies inside. And we want it to keep cooking that skin off. And Eric's a clean freak, so I don't like messiness. Anyway, it's even pushing the edges out. So go, little bag, go. Okay, a couple more minutes, and then I'll do my thing. And you can see how steamy it is inside there. All right, stop, Eric. It's not Pillsbury. All right, I'll be back. Bye. Okay, it looks like we're good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this camera around, and I'm going to set it on this shelf in this kitchen. And I'm hoping this works. So please forgive me. So what I'm going to do is, because I need to get the skins off. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this out, and I save my bags because I'm poor. And so then what we need to do is, you can see the bag, the green chilies here. So let's pull this out. Nice. Look at them steaming. Oh my gosh. So now what we have to do is we got to rip the skin off. You see how easy it comes off? And so we skin these green chilies, and where it's not really cooked, it'll stick. And then you'll end up pulling away the green, like see here how the green chilies kind of stuck to that? So the more you cook it, the better off you are. And so, you know, obviously this is a friggin' toaster oven. And so it makes it a little difficult at best. So let's pull that out. So that is the skin that we've removed. And there's little pieces of green chili here. I wonder if this is a hot green chili or, let me see if I can peel off a piece of this and taste it. Ooh, that's really good. Okay, so did I get all the skin off? I think I did. So I think that one's really good. Oh, a little bit on the tip here. That looks good. That looks good. Now the seeds are going to be pretty hot, I would think. We'll try some of those in a second. So what I'm going to do with these is I'm going to make, like, for the next couple of days, I'll make either omelets with green chilies, or I'll make scrambled eggs with green chilies and ham or whatever we do. Here, let's see. Here. You know, and these didn't, I mean, it's hard because if they stuck together better, I could certainly make, what do they call those? Chili Rellenos. And then fill it with ham and then fry it and stuff. So that looks good too. Let's put that over on our plate. And that one looks good too. Did we get all the ones off of this? I think that looks pretty good, except for the end. So which end is hotter? The end where it grows towards the bottom or the top where the seeds are? That's a good question. So now see how this is green here? This is going to stick. Yeah, see how that does that? So if I would have done a better job of baking that one or blistering that one, it would have come out better. But that's life. So Eric, is this worth all this work? I don't know. What else are you going to do in Hungary? Besides see churches, basilicas, castles, museums, river cruises. Okay. Anyway, let's get all this skin off. And so what's underneath is the green chili. That's the part that we want to eat. Can I return the skin for my money back because I didn't use it? No. You know, and again, this isn't the best approach because of the oven, but you know, what the heck. Okay, so that looks pretty. Let me get that on this plate too. Okay, so after, and you'll see that there's little, like, I don't know if you guys can see this little piece right here. So it sticks to it, and so you don't want that in your eggs if you can avoid it. Okay, so now this one looks really perfect, huh? And this one, is that, yeah, that's no good, no bueno, molto bueno. Okay, so that looks like it's perfect. So I'm gonna chop this off. And we don't really want all the seeds, but okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this, and we're gonna take a brave bite. Okay, let me rinse my fingers off so I can touch my camera. Okay. Let me get it to myself here. Okay, there we go. Get that up there, double click that. Okay, so now it's on tracking. Pretty nice, huh? Okay, so here's that little bite that we just set. Ready? And so I'm going to try this. Wow. Ooh, got a little bit of bite. Wow. That is wonderful. You know, it's a piece of home, and it is wonderful. And thank you for coming along and sharing this experience with me of doing green chilies in a toaster oven in Budapest, Hungary. And the only reason I did this is because they were on sale, and they were so cheap, I couldn't resist. Anyway, that's it for me. Thanks for coming along, everybody. Have a great day. Be safe.